Nice how a gong can bring people to attention and to quiet. I often use a gong in the beginning and end of class at UK where I teach. And just invite people to listen to the sound going into silence. And, well, that's why we're here in a way, to listen to the sound going into silence in a way that clears our minds and opens our hearts so that we can enjoy this remarkable music. I'm Lance Brunner, and I've been a member of the center for 37 years, I guess, and very proud that a place like this in Lexington exists where people can come and in a safe place, sometimes we call it the art of being human, of just being oneself and in community that supports that. And part of that is, this is a meditation center, but as you could plainly see, it's also a center for the arts. So we have a wonderful art gallery that Carl is the curator of and does an amazing job, Carl Lindstrom. And I think for the past, maybe 20 years, have had been able to sponsor organized concerts here in a program I call Music as Sacred Path. And the idea is that we can use our sense of hearing, our audition, to connect with sound in a way that connects us to the present moment. You could say the magic of the present moment. And sound is also a way that connects us as a community, right? And the kind of listening that we do. So I am in a very fortunate position because I'm a professor of musicology or music history at the University of Kentucky, and also the director of graduate studies, and have the most amazing students, I must boast. Really astonishing. Great musicians, great human beings. It's just an inspiration. And I invite them to come here to play, and also maybe to introduce them to a different kind of listening, a different kind of performance, that it's not just playing for a large public or an anonymous public that comes maybe with the idea of hearing perfection because listening to recordings all the time, the music that's played perfectly or whatever, of a different kind of space in which you can make music, which is a contemplative space. And unlike the many other programs that I've sponsored, I don't have a plan for this. I just have the great musicians invited them. And Beth Merrill is in my class. She's a freshman from Louisville, a harpist, obviously. And I teach a class on meditation and yoga for musicians, and she's in it. She's only a freshman, but she said, "Oh, I've been practicing for years." You know, so she's quite extraordinary in that sense of maturity and a practice that really transforms. And also JeeHee Kang and Darryl Manley, who you'll hear shortly, violin and viola. JeeHee is from Korea, and Darryl is from
Florida.
Weird places, distant places, yeah. I've invited them to play as well, and I think they have prepared several pieces, and they, I also, to see if we can make some improvisation maybe, and also those of you who are here have heard Anna perform a beautiful song. She is Craig and Susan Smith-Sargent's daughter, and a very highly skilled, developed vocalist with her own songs and covering songs. And she said, "But I don't have my instrument." I said, "Well, you have three instruments here, even though they're not hers." And see what I've invited her to sing something, and we can see what happens. And this might be another aspect of what's called deep listening. Deep listening is a practice in which you're listening 24/7, and when you stop listening or get distracted, you simply come back to the sound. In deep listening practice, there are no wrong notes. it's all part of the same piece or soundscape. So the musicians have a break. They don't have to worry about perfection, of just how the music feels and offering it. In that respect, I would say let's sit quietly and meditate, working with the breath or with sound, before and invite Beth to sit for a few minutes whenever you feel the space is ready or you're ready, play for us. And I would invite people not to applaud at the end, but to see what it feels like in that space. Because right? Applause, of course, shows our appreciation and our enthusiasm for the music, but it also breaks the mood, doesn't it? With the cacophony of applause, as well-meaning as it is. And we, at the end, or somehow, will be appropriate to applaud. So let's begin with a little bit of silence, and you begin when you're ready.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, this was some of that forbidden stuff.
Okay, forbidden technique. Yeah. Don't let Elaine know that I did this. Because
I've traveled far, sometimes with conscience flying.